listener. Good evening, Mzansi. Your primetime team is locked and ready to serve you some of the latest trending stories. You are tuned in to TrendingSA right here on SABC 3. I am Mable, and I'm coming to you with the best of the best in the business. She speaks her mind. She's beautiful. She's insanely funny.
Oh.
It's Lesego Tlhabi.
Oh my God. First of all, happy birthday, Gogoshi. I love you. My grandmother is 81 today.
Now, Mo is stuck at some remote village somewhere DJing. You know the kind of gigs that he gets, Shane. Please give him more gigs. Right. So the man that's here to replace him for today and Friday is a man that did it differently. You know how you become a celebrity and then when things go bad, you then take off your clothes? Well, he took off his clothes first and then became a celebrity.
I'm not complaining.
And he joins us tonight as a guest host. It's TV presenter, Dr. Fess.
Wow, guys. I don't know if that's a warm reception or if it's a cold reception. What the heck? I'm happy to be here and I can't wait to give you guys all the news.
I'm very happy you're here.
Thank you. And I'm clothed. Just for you guys.
For now.
Just for now. So we know the level. The levels. But speaking of trending, can we just give a shout out to Nomza Mombatha, who has officially started her press run for the much anticipated Coming to America sequel. So she's scheduled to actually appear on the international talk show The Real. This is big news, guys. It's massive to promo the movie. So I mean, what do you think about her style, her grace? She's exuding everything right now.
Those shoes, guys, I want to eat her shoes. Move. Literally.
I didn't even notice that. Like, I noticed the gold on the heel and I was just like, yes, this Nomza has gone.
She looks like a museum, and then she also looks Hollywood. She looks like she fits right in.
Do you know why she actually has that gold on the heel? Because she's stepping on everybody's necks.
Oh! And on that note, it's time for Top Trends.
Sometimes flaunting what you got can get you into hot water. So no one knows this better than businessman Hamilton Ndlovu. Oh, my Lord. He popped up on the timeline after the Pretoria Division of the Gauteng High Court confirmed that he owes SARS 36 rands and needs to pay now.
Yo. Guys, if you don't know who the flashy businessman is and why he's topical news, well, here's a quick rundown. He first popped up on our timelines at the height of lockdown. I'm sorry to be smiling like this. After posting a video on social media boasting about a purchase of a fleet of luxury vehicles. Look at that, guys.
Guys, I mean, just stay off social media. This flashy act thrust him into the spotlight and on SARS and the Hawks' radar. Soon afterwards, the SARS launched an investigation into his financial affairs. Oh, Gosiam. Twitter didn't miss a thing, and this is what they had to say.
Guys, so we finally weighed in with this. The pain and stress that Hamilton Ndlovu might be going through right now cannot be compared to anything. A young black man who was trying out life and business is being brought down by the same system that says they want to empower young black business men and women. And Uzak Mdeni said the lesson with Hamilton Ndlovu's case should be for everyone to pay their taxes as opposed to enjoying your riches in private. There's no need to hide your flashy lifestyle if you do things right. I mean, And finally, from A.M. Matabo, I wouldn't even have an Instagram account if I had Hamilton Ndlovu money. No lies there.
Straight away.
No lies there.
This is not the first time someone has ratted themselves out to officials on social media and practically delivered themselves to the police on a silver platter. Do you guys remember Sam Holding and his convoy to the Durban July?
I do. Guys,
and the thing is, we didn't know about him. We really had no idea who he was until this.
Actually, but are these his cars?
It's his cars.
I mean, listen, I feel like at least he has the video, so he'll always remember the day. And we have the news to remember him by.
That's ridiculous. That's so ostentatious. My gosh.
Wow.
I can't. It's too much.
But, guys, how about rapper Bobby Shmurda about a week ago basically rapped his way to jail after detailing a crime in his lyrics. Guys, that's the ultimate flex, Scott. I have to just put it out there. You doing the things when
How would you do it if you committed a crime in South Africa? Like, rap that.
Like, you know, you gotta hit me with the beat. I mean, listen, I'm a doctor, I'm not a rapper.
I mean, it's one thing to out yourself, but then when you go and name your crew, I think that was where I was like, my guy, How are you snitching? Speaking of snitches, this guy, oh my word, he snitched on his own mother, who was a VP for a major footwear brand, and spoke to a journalist who ratted himself out for reselling the brand's footwear and sharing all the inside info.
What an
idiot. Mama must have.
Guys, you know, impi impi when you're ratting out your own mother. Like, come on.
Your own mom.
Guys, moving on. Back in 2019, Instagram announced that they were toying around with the idea of hiding Instagram likes in an effort to reduce anxiety amongst users, to alleviate societal pressures. Now, before you get rattled, what they meant was that you, as somebody who's posting, you can see your own likes, but the people that are viewing your Instagram page can't see your likes. So now everybody would be sitting on practically zero. So earlier on today, Instagram comms tweeted this: we've been testing this new experience to hide likes on feed posts. We intentionally added more people to the test today, which was a bug. We're fixing this issue and restoring the counts to those people as soon as possible.
Guys, so Tweeps quickly jumped onto this with some concerns and with some jubilation as well at the prospect of having the likes removed. I don't know how you guys are feeling about it, but here's Leanne Love, who said influencers need to base their stats on something else that isn't so mentally tolling for other users, primarily for the younger users. Take away the like count for good. She's very adamant to actually have it taken away. And then we have Usatana Jones. If their livelihood or financial survival doesn't depend on engagement, they really need to be taught how to get over it. The numbers are meaningless. I mean, guys, I don't know. What do you guys think about it? Because I know without the likes, you can kind of start coming out the shell. You can post things like your feet because you think your feet are cute thinking I'll get one like Uma.
I just think I agree with Satan Jones.
Where's going with Satan?
That was the microaggression. Satan.
That's her name in South Africa. You guys are saying Satana. Satan Jones said, I agree with her. Being an influencer or being somebody who makes money off of the app, we kind of need the like count because...
with likes and how many people actually show that they like them. So maybe it is a good thing. Mental health
wise. Some people just don't engage. I mean, I get it, but some people just honestly, sometimes I go to Instagram and I just watch stories. If I saw a lot of posts, I would like them all. I just don't really engage with posts. I like all your posts. You're all beautiful.
For me, I'm really happy that for our mental health, people are just going to wake up and post a cup of coffee and just chill. You know what I'm saying? Like everybody now, it's a photo shoot to be on Instagram.
We make our money there, some of us.
I just want to post my feet.
I will teach you. Ask me how.
I just want to post my feet without feeling self-conscious.
Not the doctor's feet.
Oh, the doctor's feet.
Oh my God.
Guys, don't move. We are going on a quick ad break and we have more top trends coming up. And later on the show, we bring you Connected Business powered by our besties at Vodacom. It's TSA on 3.
Body like one dump, looks so good and now I'm some. Welcome back. It's TSA on 3. And as we count down to the much anticipated Meghan Markle and Prince Harry sit down with the Queen of Primetime Television, Oprah Winfrey, numerous news outlets have been recalling the good, the bad. And I have to give it drama, guys. This is a story about the royals. But this time, it looks like the Duchess has won a comprehensive victory in the form of an interim payment of Dr. Fez's salary, 9.4 million rand, against the UK newspaper group that published a private letter of hers back in 2019.
Guys, we are trying to shoot a serious show here. So basically, if you don't know about this letter, it was a personal and private letter that Meghan had penned to his estranged father, Thomas Markle, pleading with him to stop talking to the press and making false claims about her in interviews. Guys, is it just me or this upcoming tell-all is unleashing a bag of smolanyana skeletons over there at the royal house?
Because I just think they couldn't hold them in for too long.
Like, Ushosenga, it's a smolanyana. Yeah. They've had bags on
it
bags.
It was Prince Andrew, then it was just and then the crown came through. I mean, and Prince Philip is now amper alive.
Yeah, but guys, why are we acting like that guy is 62?
Exactly. That's what
I understand. You always need to fight for patience. You always need to fight for everybody counts. Just remember
that. But it's
that.
Also like, at what age do you stop giving organs? Really? Like,
you keep
at 99, giving. You don't need a new heart. You need to do what the Lord is telling you and go home.
Guys, and I can't wait for, okay, this is going to come out wrong. I just can't wait for the headlines when you finally, you know, meets with his makeup, because it's going to be the same way. Headlines. Goes, oh, what happened? And like, he's 99.
Gone too soon.
I mean,
gone
too listen, soon. At least Megan's going to get a break then, because I feel like the press has been hounding her. So in his last dying breath, he'll give her something.
No, for some reason, they're going to blame her for his death. Black lady in looks at
him and dies. Have become our daily norm on social media? And we bumped into a challenge where, you guys know these ones, you don't have to say, but you post something and we kind of know what you're about. Mm. So we decided to throw that out to South Africa and see what you guys can do. And our challenge is, tell us you're a millennial without telling us that you're a millennial.
Mm. Huh?
What do you guys think?
Mm-hmm. So Tweeps jumped at this challenge very, very well. And we gave the AMA2000/Gen Z proper FOMO with the responses. And we had this to say. East Side Low took us down memory lane. With this, I see Bebo. I recognize Dragon Ball Z and Tezo.
Did you just call it Bebo?
Is it Bibo?
Bebo. C-Shy.
Bebo. You said Bebo.
I don't know who the lady in the corner is, but
Sabrina.
Guys, Sabrina.
Sabrina was human, guys. We saw it in like real life. We didn't watch a cartoon version. On this, whatever. Anyway, Straw Hat Mo gave us FOMO with this.
This was the worst phone ever made.
It looks like a console. I don't understand why you'd want
worst
to text
phone.
And then it went like
guys,
this.
Guys, I feel like I always wanted this Nokia phone. It went 3310 and then it went this. This was my dream phone right here.
It's because doctors love having their phones, keys, tablets, what on the table, watches.
Guys, I feel like out here, people are trying to attack doctors, but fronters, we're out here saving the world.
And what? Women get choked with this. I know my rights. That's a millennial. I know my rights.
Guys, I would like to know from you, how do you say that you're a millennial without actually saying that you're a millennial, Nina?
Okay.
Because I'm assuming you're millennial.
I will just go straight into it. Bam! The Ericsson T10. They're out of business. We miss them. This phone was a status symbol. Karabo Moroka carried a blue version of this phone. Queen Moroka carried the yellow one. And this phone was the only phone that actually replaced when cell phones came through. You could actually argue with someone and then have something to slam. Like, umchwelaga.
I feel like I've never thought about it in that way.
Because he's always fighting. Anyway, before streaming services, we had this.
Oh.
Icon. Guys, do you remember when you had to like rewind it physically?
Yes.
Before they went out of business, that's probably why. Because we have to sit there, rewind your own videos, take them back. And if you got one that wasn't rewinded, you're now watching the whole movie backwards, getting spoiler alerts before you can watch it.
It was common courtesy because it wasn't like a DVD that you put it in and it starts from the beginning. So it was common courtesy. Say, watch the movie and rewind it.
I never rewinded it. I was a bad boy. Before search engines, excuse me, you could actually find I'm a panel beta, all the people that you needed to find in my go-to yellow pages.
Doctor.
You know, still keep that under my bed. To just keep it level. So shout out to Yellow Pages. Always
I want to talk about the book that came with the Yellow Pages. Ooh. You actually got the phone book that came with the Yellow Pages. Mm. And that's the worst thing that we had in our time, because it will have Lesego Tlhabi, 08 what, and then it will have 11 Bath Avenue. What? So basically anybody who just knows your name and surname and where you live, they would actually...
I don't live at 11 Bath Avenue, by the way.
Guys, please. These guys are showing their age. Angazi, enjoy my telephone books. Anyway, moving right along. So, last night, I was scrolling through my timeline, as I do at 1 o'clock. Mm-hmm. I stumbled upon an interesting tweet from DJ and entrepreneur, DJ Zintle. Mm. Take a look. She said, do you ever get tired of being a good person? I'm just asking for a friend. I get that.
I do get it.
I get that because...
I mean, I do, but also is it like good versus maybe like the difference between good and naive or good and walkover? Mm. I don't know. I mean, maybe that's what she's
referring to. I want to ask you,
yeah.
Do you ever get tired?
my job does not allow me to get tired. I feel like you always, the one person you don't want, masungena, and you've stabbed yourself. Why did you stab yourself?
Okay.
I know, please, just
unless they go to Prince Mkhize.
I was going to say, not the hospital you work at.
Yeah. For me, Lisa, do you want to go?
No, I said what I said. I mean, I just think, first of all, though, I used to be that person. I think I would have complained the same way 3-4 years ago. Now you go low,
you go.
I go lower.
I'm the type of person where you can put a bunch of people. Some people believe that I'm the nicest person that I that they've ever met. Some people believe I'm the meanest person that they've ever met because I'm an energy mirror. So what you give me is what I give out.
Did not know that there was a nice part.
I also was like, who says the nicest?
I've heard about the other one.
I say the other one. I don't know about the nicest.
That being said, it's time for a commercial break. And when we come back, Vodacom connects small businesses with tools for success. It's time.
Welcome back to Welcome back to Ta On. The COVID-19 pandemic has disrupted how we conduct our businesses. So Vodacom is connecting small businesses with tools for success with their bespoke smart business solutions. The next interview segment is brought to you by Vodacom Business, keeping SMEs connected.
Now, Pineapple is a South African insurtech startup that was founded by a trio that got together as part of an innovation competition run by Hanover during 2016 in an effort to find disruptive models in the insurance space. Co-founder Ndabenhle Junior Ngulube joins us tonight to discuss the trajectory of this business. Welcome to the show, Ndabenhle.
Welcome. So, Ndabenhle, Pineapple has disrupted the traditional short-term insurance models and offered competitive pricing and cloud-based solutions. Please tell us about other ways you are distinguishing yourself from competitors in the market, sir.
Really, at Pineapple, we distinguish ourselves based on two pillars. The first being ease of use, and the second being our business model. Just to touch on the two of those very briefly, with ease of use, with Pineapple, ensuring your items, be it your cell phone, laptop, furniture, and your vehicle, is as simple as just taking a picture of that item, and pretty much in less than 1 minute, you are insured. This is something that's never been done before in insurance and a great user experience. In terms of our actual business model, so what we do at Pineapple is that we make our money by taking a fixed fee of monthly premium. And whatever money is left over after we've taken our fee is in essence used to pay for the claims of Pineapple members. And after 12 months, whatever money has not been used to pay out claims is in essence distributed back to the Pineapple members. So we have no incentive to deny claims because we've already made our money. If you contrast that to the traditional insurance companies, they in essence make money by denying claims.
I'm just so proud because I've known him since he was like little boy. So I'm like, little one. Anyway, so as a grown businessman, you've created a cloud-based solution that has transformed, how has this transformed your business and how can it also potentially revolutionize the insurance market? English is killing me.
One thing that cloud-based infrastructure has done for us is that it allows us to move incredibly fast compared to the traditional players. So we can roll out new features in a matter of days compared to the number of weeks or sometimes months that it takes these traditional guys to roll out those features. So that allows us to stay nimble and stay competitive.
So Ndabenhle, COVID has changed how businesses operate. What are some of the smart business solutions that you guys have implemented to help you be more efficient, productive, and ultimately useful?
So I'll answer those questions on two fronts. Firstly, our customers. So we have a very new and sleek insurance product that's going to be coming out very soon for our motor policyholders, where in it, the less you drive, the less premiums you stand to pay for your monthly insurance policy. So that's something that's really going to go away in terms of making us relevant for how business is changing in terms of COVID. As a startup, we have fully adopted the work from home way of doing things. So our entire company is working remotely. And what's interesting is that that has made us even more productive than we were when we were actually in the office. So it's been a great learning curve for us.
Oh. Okay, well, thank you so much. I will see you at Rocket soon, I'm sure. Thanks, Nda. So whether you require fast, reliable internet for your business, marketing or business funding, Vodacom Business is helping SMEs grow their business with their smart business solutions, keeping business connected.
And Vodacom Business is dedicated to growing businesses and is even prepared to help wherever possible to ensure that they do succeed. Start doing business the smart way. Dr. Fez, thank you so much for joining us. And I hear that you are coming back on Friday.
I have made sure that
I feel like I've caught this bug. I feel like this feels very comfortable.
Mo,
wherever you are, in the corner, in playing turnstiles.
Lizeko, you mustn't get too excited because here at TrendingSA, we work on first come, first in, first out. So if somebody's, if we do retrenchments, you're the last person to
just give it to a vote. I just feel like vote if you'd rather see me or my stay behind. Because I think this looks good on TV. I think this looks good in real life. I think this looks good in a wedding album. I think this looks good in a bit.
No, COVID, guys, COVID.
Anyway, we've come to the end of another great show. It is still 6:30, guys. Children are watching. Make sure to tune in tomorrow. We have more stories for you right here on 3. See you then. Wow.